In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
God of all mercy and consolation, come to the help of your people, turning us from our sin to live for you alone. Give us the power of your Holy Spirit, that we may confess our sin, receive your forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us. So that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth.
Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God,
you have knit your people together in one communion.
In the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Grant us grace to follow your blessed saints in lives of faith and commitment, and to know the inexpressible joys you have prepared for those who love you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
First reading, Revelation 7:9-17. After this, I looked and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God, who is seated on the throne and the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures, and they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, singing, "Amen, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one that knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night with his temple, and the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of the water of life, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." The word of the Lord. Second reading, 1 John 3:1-3. "See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that I did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves just as he is pure." The word of the Lord.
Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Alleluia. The gospel for this All Saints Sunday comes from Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of God. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Well, here we are at another All Saints Sunday. We'll be remembering names in a little while, lighting candles, ringing a chime, and again, just thinking back to the wonderful people whom we've lost in this last year. Our texts for this morning also give us a little bit of a glimpse of saints, whether it's saints living now or saints who have died and are now with God. One of the wonderful ways that saints are portrayed is in the Revelation text. And I know sometimes Revelation seems weird and difficult and with all its symbols and language. And some of that is in this text. But this wonderful way of looking at the saints of all tribes and nations, languages, of all shapes and sizes and colors. It's a wonderful way of looking at all saints. But in another way, it's a wonderful way of recognizing or perhaps remembering that we are all together in this. That faith is something we do together, not alone. That life is something we do together, not alone. Whether it's struggles or hardships, whether it's celebrations and joys, we tend to do these together in community, with family, with friends, with congregations, with co-workers, with classmates. It's a wonderful way of looking at what it means to be a saint or to be a part of this body that God has put together through his Son, Jesus Christ, the Lamb. Have any of you ever tried that game, 6 degrees from separation? You know, the one where you come up with another name and then you try to make connections from yourself to that person within 6 people, within 6 degrees. And they say most of the time that we can do it, that we can get to somebody, perhaps even someone we don't even know, within 6 contacts, 6 people. However, in our Revelation text, and even somewhat in the gospel too, there's a wonderful expression that's not, it's not written in there, but it's one that came through tradition, and it's got a great Latin name to it. It's called Coram Deo. It means in the presence of God, or in the midst of the face of God. That these saints in Revelation, or even those who were with Jesus on the mountaintop in Matthew's gospel, were in the presence of God. They were Coram Deo. They were no degrees of separation. Sometimes it does feel like God is at least 2 or 3 or 4 degrees of separation at times in our lives. But in these texts, there is a promise that God will be at 0 degrees, that we will be in the presence of the face of God. This is a wonderful healthy image, especially in the times that we've been seeing ourselves in these last 6-7 months, these times of separation, these times of chaos and loss and anxiety, of division. And I know that even here in the next couple of days, we're going to be going through a huge transition. And there's going to be a lot of division and chaos. Hopefully, not extreme. But this text brings us back. This text shows us that what God has done and continues to do through Jesus Christ is to keep us in his presence. Coram Deo. Together, all of us. Again, we may all have some differences, opinions, but we are together under the cross of Christ. We are 0 degrees of separation from God, because God has done what needs to be done. We are all in the presence of God through the cross of Jesus Christ, through the promise of resurrection through Jesus Christ. Our lives are God's. At our baptisms, we were marked with the cross of Christ forever on our foreheads. I always like to think that we were branded, but that's a little extreme. That we are washed in the waters of baptism. We were told that the Holy Spirit is present not only then, but now. That our sins are forgiven. That doesn't mean that we have somehow this ability to be sinless. Or even those in the Revelation text are sinless. Or even powerful people. They're all people like us. Make mistakes. Hurt our neighbors. Label people. But we have a God who has said, come to me. Come to me. Confess your sins and know that you will be forgiven. Treat people well. Treat them kindly. The Beatitudes is a long line of ethics, right? It's a long line of knowing how to live in this community of saints. How to live in the presence of God in 0 degrees of separation. How do we continue to live in this? How do we adapt to what we're doing right now? I mean, I think we've been doing a pretty good job these last few months. We've had bumps, scrapes, technology, hurdles. But God continues to bring to us the good news every week, every day, that Jesus Christ is our Savior and Lord, that what was done on the cross and was answered by resurrection is ours, our gift that keeps on giving. And we're just asked to live that life. Live that life knowing what God has done for us first. To extend grace. To extend mercy. To extend joy. To extend life. I'd like to just once again say that as we light the candles here in a little bit, as we remember those who have died in the last year. That it is in those white robes from Revelation that they now sit in. That it is those white robes that we wore at baptism. It is those white robes that clothe us in the midst of the community. And even though these people in the Revelation text, they have come through the great tribulation, right? They've come through the blood and the muck, and their robes have been washed clean, washed white. And I can't think of a better way of using that metaphor as through the pandemic that we've had, of all the muck and the blood. Again, the anxiety, the separation, the lives that we have lost. We've worn those robes a long time. Feels like a long time. But Christ washes them white. That God is still with us, even in the midst of this. God walks with us, 0 degrees of separation. Guides us, consoles us, supports us. Maybe in ways that we don't quite see or hear or understand, but that's the promise. And by faith, by trust, we say, thank you, God. Thank you for being my God. Thank you, Jesus, for being my Savior. For the one who looks after me, who looks over and over again over my own inabilities, my sin, and says, you are a loved one. You I know. You I have saved and will continue and always love. That is the promise. That is the community in which we have put our faith in. That is the community we will continue to be. You are all the saints. Wear your white robes proudly and share Jesus throughout your days and your lives. Amen.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord. Precious Lord, linger near when my life is almost gone. Hear my cry, hear my call, hold my hand lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me on. Darkness appears and the night draws near and the day is past and gone. At the river I stand, guide my
And now we're going to remember those who have died in the past year and others of our friends and family. By the lighting of candles and the ringing of a chime, we remember first those from our congregation and those connected to our congregation who have died in the past year. After we finish with the large candles, then Paula is going to begin lighting the smaller candles, and I'll be reading the names of those that you shared with us. Waltred York. Leroy York. Grace Carlson. Jonathan Boyer. Lonnie Day. Joan Gunby. Margaret Gilcrease. Omar Stunkel. Dale Shirey. Al Ellison. Mel Carlson. Walter Bauer, Bob Bowman, Marsha Bemis, Lori Booth, Coralie Costa, Betty Kramer, Bob Drummond, Megan Ferris, Richard Green, Linda Inman, Danny Kjorkis, Judy Kunkel, Betty Lay, Marilyn Lloyd, Connie Martin, Richard Martin, Walt Mosman, Dick Oberg, Velda Oster, James Rockhold, Winifred Romberger, Keith Shipbaugh, Dale Stodden, Oscar Stout, Jean Vile, Penny Wakefield, Ed Wilson. And if there's any that you wish to add now, please do so in your mind and in your heart, and we will light a candle. Lord, we give you thanks for these wonderful saints, for their time here on earth, for all the ways that they taught and shared, that they served and loved. We pray that we may continue to live that life which you have given to all of us, that life of grace and mercy and peace. peace and of that life everlasting that begins now and will always be. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray. Amen. Let us proclaim our Christian faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The prayers of the people. I will be ending each petition with, "Hear us, O God," and your response will be, "Your mercy is great." Longing for Christ's reign to come among us, we pray for the outpouring of God's power on the church, the world, and all in need. Lord of all saints, we praise you for evangelists and martyrs whose sacrifices witness to your gospel across time and space. Inspire us by their courage to carry our faith to new people and places around us. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Lord of every place, the universe proclaims your greatness from generation to generation. Bless the work of naturalists, conservationists, and park rangers who train our attention to the wonders of the world you have made. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Lord of every nation, guide this country, red states and blue states, rural voters and urban voters, young and old, as we share in another national election. Kindle hearts eager to understand our common needs and seek our common good. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Lord of every blessing, your Son's blessing came to those living with poverty, grief, hunger, thirst, and persecution. Shape our vision of the saints to match his own. Awaken in us your call to serve all who suffer. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Lord of every venture, anoint us with the missionary spirit of the early church. Bless all new missions of our synod. Empower testimony from the new communities of faith to shape a diverse witness to your saving power. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. For what else do the people of God pray, either in our hearts or aloud? We would like to lift up Jan Madden, Dale Yates, Dennis, Daryl and Diane Buck and family as they mourn the passing of Diane's mother, Chris Conway, Lillian Inman, Jody. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Lord of every time, countless are the multitudes you have called by name and gathered to yourself. Comfort us as we grieve those who have died in the past year. In faith, may we join with them in ceaseless praise. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Receive our prayers in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior, until that day when you gather all creation around your throne, where you will reign forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is our duty and delight that we should everywhere and always offer thanks and praise to you, O God, through Jesus Christ, to whom you and all the saints and martyrs bore witness with their lives. And so with the church on earth, all creation and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, 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 holy are you, God of power and might. Heaven and earth are filled with your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in your name. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, gracious, and merciful God. Everything is filled with your glory. We give you thanks for your promise and presence, which have sustained the faithful in this and every generation. Above all, we give you thanks for Jesus, born of Mary, who in word and deed announced your gentle rule of justice, reconciliation, and peace. On the night of his betrayal, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Make us bold, O merciful God, to address you as our Abba as we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The gifts of God for the people of God. Come, all things are now ready. If you wish now to take your bread and your wine, remember, if you're with another person, please serve them, and then have the other person serve you. If you're by yourself, you're more than welcome to say the words to yourself. The body of Christ given for you. The blood of Christ shed for you.
Of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us peace.
The body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in God's grace. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Life-giving God, in the mystery of Christ's resurrection, you send light to conquer darkness, water to give new life, and the bread of life to nourish your people and free us from fear. Send us forth as witnesses to your Son's resurrection, that we may show your glory to all the world. Through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Amen.
Shall we gather at the river where bright angel feet have trod, with its crystal tide forever flowing by the throne of God? Yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful river. Gather with the saints at the river that flows by the throne of God. On the margin of the river, washing up its silver spray, we will walk and worship ever all the happy golden day. Yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful river. Gather with the saints at the river that flows by the throne of God. Ere we reach the shining river, lay we every burden down. Grace our spirits will deliver and provide a robe and crown. Yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful river. Gather with the saints at the river that flows by the throne of God. Soon we'll reach the shining river, soon our pilgrimage will cease, soon our happy hearts will quiver with the melody of peace. Yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful river. Gather with the saints at the river that flows by the throne of God.
As the people of God, this is our mission at Advent, called by God's grace to love and serve. Go in peace, serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.